Hi, Ria here. Today I want to show you an envelope flip book that I created with the paper pad from Crafter's Companion. It's the vintage florals. It has all those nice pink, green, dark colors in it. And yes, I know it's unbelievable. There is no purple in it and I like it. Yes, doesn't happen much, but today it is so. So, when I was looking for something today in my craft room, I came across a box of envelopes. So I was like, oh, I dropped everything. And I created an envelope flip book. It opens like this. And on the inside, I used all the elements and the papers from the vintage florals paper pack. I really love that you get all these elements with the paper pack. You only have to push them out and maybe use your scissors around the corners or around the outside, outer lines. Oh, there we go again. Me with forgetting how things are called. That's the fibro. That's causing a brain fog sometimes. Oh, this is hilarious. So, I used the envelopes to create these little pockets where you can stuff things in. I have one pocket on this side and there are two on this side. Maybe I should have kept it for one, but I thought, oh, why not two? It's not personalized yet because I don't know for who it's going to be. So it's empty, no text, nothing. But I did use the little cutting dies. Okay, let me grab those. They are from the frames and accessories element set that you use with the Precious Moments memory book. Also from Crafter's Companion, of course. If you want to know the article number. There it is. I'm not gonna say it because I'm not gonna pronounce it right. So I'm not even gonna try it. But in this set you get a lot of really useful dies. There are some, maybe it's easier to show this way. You have some words, baby, family, memories, Christmas, holiday. And there is this little photo frame with a flower. You have this little beautiful ornament die. There's another beautiful one here. But I didn't use these all. I just used this one. These are the four corners. And I double cut them out of chipboard. So they are raised. And they are a bit stronger so I could use them to with the string. So I could close the booklet. And that's that's holding pretty good so far. It really is. I glued it with the tacky glue from Crafter's Companion and it really stays on. So on the back side I use this. So it's just for personal, to make it personal for the person that I'm gonna give it to. So right, Ria. Get over it, talk, to raise some of the elements, because you don't want them all flat. I use some double-sided foam tapes, not too thick, just thin stripes. You can use the you can use it behind the butterflies to raise the wings. That's what I did here too on the front. So it's not all so flat. I don't like it if it's all flat. So, well, that's what I wanted to show you. Oh yeah, this on this side. It's also not flat. And I even double cut this. I know it's a shame to use two elements just for one. But for this one I thought it would be pretty. And here's a little notepad that you can get out. And you can write something on it. Yeah, okay. I don't know what to say else. I really like it and I think it's something else for me. There's no stitching on it. Yeah, I know. I really must be going crazy. No stitching, no coloring, no inking. Ria, what's happening? Yeah, well, Ria's a little tired. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, I hope you liked it. Goodbye. Bye-bye.